Hello, in this video we will solve one problem on RLC network. So circuit is given here. We have a resistor of 6 ohm and inductor with 7 Henry inductance and capacitance 1/42 farad. And already the initial values are given, that is voltage across capacitor V of 0 is 0 and I of 0 is 10 ampere, so current passing through the inductor is also given. So it means that VC of 0 minus equal to VC of 0 plus equal to V of 0 plus, that equal to 0. Okay, similarly same thing applies to inductor also. So since inductor resists abrupt change in current and capacitor resists abrupt change in voltage, so once V of 0 is given means VC of 0 plus we know and VC of 0 minus also we know. Okay, so before that we will just see that what will be the response. The response will dependent on alpha and omega naught value. If alpha is greater than omega naught, the response is overdamped. If it is less than, underdamped, equal, it is critically damped. Okay, so in this one first we have to determine that one. So alpha is expression we know, alpha is 1/2 RC, and if you substitute this resistor and capacitor value, we will get 3.5. Similarly, omega naught is 1/√LC, we have seen in the previous video. Omega naught is 1/√LC and it is √6. Now if you compare alpha and omega naught, so you will see that alpha is greater than omega naught. So we will understand that okay, response will be overdamped. Response will be overdamped. And how to calculate S1 and S2? Two roots we have to calculate. And root S1 is nothing but minus alpha plus under the square root of alpha square minus omega naught square. And S2 will be minus alpha minus under the square root alpha square minus omega naught square. So that if you substitute and calculate, you will get S1 equal to minus 1 and S2 equal to minus 6. So we know the solution now, V of t equal to, it is sum of two exponents, A1 e power S1 t plus A2 e power S2 t, where S1 is minus 1, S2 is minus 6. Now only thing remaining is we have to calculate this A1 and A2. So how we can calculate? We know two initial conditions, that is V of 0 and I of 0 we know. Can we use those initial conditions to determine A1 and A2? We will see that. So from V of 0, we know that V of 0 is already given, it is 0. So that we will substitute here. V of 0 will be, in this equation t equal to 0, then it will be A1 plus A2. So A1 plus A2 equal to 0. Why it is 0? Because initial condition it is given, so 0 is given, so that's why you have to equate to 0. So we have one equation relating A1 and A2, that is A1 plus A2 equal to 0. But we need one more equation to determine A1 and A2, because we have two unknowns, we need two equations. So one weak equation already we derived with the help of V of 0. So if you want to solve for A1 and A2, we need another expression relating A1 and A2. How we can get that one? Remember, we already know one more initial condition, that is current through inductor. Can we use that one? So idea will be like this. Since IL of 0 or 0 plus, both are same in this case, IL of 0 plus and VC of 0 plus is known, it is given in the problem. From this known, we can calculate first I of 0 plus. What do you mean by I of 0 plus? IR of 0 plus. IR of 0 plus means, I will show that, we know the initial voltage across capacitor we know. From that value, you can calculate the current through the resistor, initial value. Initial current through this resistor can be found, because we know VC of 0 plus. Okay, so that is the first step. We will we from this given values we can calculate IR of 0 plus. Once we know IR of 0 plus, we can easily calculate IC of 0 plus, because from the Kirchhoff's current law, IR and I of 0 plus also we know, current through the inductor we know, current through the resistor we calculated, current through the capacitor also we can calculate. So, but one more relationship we have, that is IC of 0 plus, the current through the capacitor at t equal to 0 is also equal to from the current voltage relationship of capacitor, that is C into dVc by dt, but we have to evaluate at t equal to 0. Since it is IC of 0 plus, we should evaluate this differential at t equal to 0. So that means dVc by dt, if you do IC of 0 plus by 0, that you can substitute. So that means V of 0 plus, we got one equation for A1 and A2. Another equation we can get from dVc by dt, where t is equal to 0, from that we can get one more expression relating A1 and A2. Because IC of 0 plus we know, not directly, from the IL of 0 plus, from that we know IC of 0 plus. So we will solve like this. Okay, so give a expression is given here, we have to differentiate first, and in that differentiation we have to make t equal to 0 and get the value first. So V of t, that is this expression, dv by dt equal to, you differentiate, you will get this expression, and you have to evaluate at t equal to 0, because the KCL what we are applying, that is at the instant t equal to 0. So that instant 0 plus, that instant 0 plus is the better, 0 plus. Okay, at t equal to 0 plus means it is nothing but t equal to 0, soon after t equal to 0. So in the expression t, you have to substitute t equal to 0. Okay, so dv by dt at t equal to 0 plus, or 0 also you can write, mathematically it is 0, but 0 plus we are writing just to indicate that it is soon after t equal to 0, just soon after. Okay, that's why it is t equal to 0 plus. For our better understanding, we are writing 0 plus, otherwise it is 0 enough. Okay, now that is equal to minus a1 minus 6 a2. You substitute t equal to 0 here in this, you will get this. But we have one more expression relating IC and dv by dt. What is that? I in the capacitor current, IC equal to C dv by dt, but I am interested in IC of 0 plus. For that, what you have to do, C into dv by dt, you have to evaluate at t equal to 0 plus. So from KCL we can equate IC, IR and I. Okay, just see here, from the KCL at t equal to 0 plus, it is sum of all leaving current, current through capacitor, current through inductor, current through resistor, sum of all currents must be 0. This is KCL at instant t equal to 0 plus. So in the above equation, that is IC equal to C dv by dt, we will substitute that at t equal to 0 plus. So it becomes IC of 0 plus equal to C dv by dt at the instant t equal to 0 or 0 plus. Okay, if it is better, you write 0 plus so that there will be no confusion. Okay, now if you evaluate that one, dv by dt, we already know, we have an expression for dv by dt, that we will keep it in the left hand side. Right hand side, it will be IC of 0 plus by C, the C will go to the denominator. So IC of 0 plus, we have a KCL expression, that is sum of all current equal to 0. So IC of 0 plus is nothing but minus I of 0 plus plus IR of 0 plus. And we know IR of 0 plus because we know the initial voltage across capacitor. Since inductor and capacitors are in parallel, we can easily calculate VC of 0 plus, sorry, we can easily calculate IR of 0 plus. So that is nothing but 0. Initial voltage across capacitor is 0. So initial current through the resistor also will be 0. And I of 0 plus is given in the problem 10 ampere. So if you substitute those two value here, we will, in left hand side, we will write dv by dt at equal to 0. We have already done the differentiation and we have substitution also we have done. That expression you put at the left hand side. Right hand side, you solve this and put here. So you will get minus 420 you will get, but everywhere if you has a, every component has minus sign, so you multiply by minus 1, so you will get a1 plus 6a2 equal to 420. So this is the equation 2. Equation 1 we have a1 plus c here, a1 plus a2 equal to 0. This is from the initial voltage condition, and we got one more, that is a1 plus 6a2 equal to 420. This is from the inductor current initial value, initial condition. From that we are getting one more equation. So solving 1 and 2 you will get the expression. You solve that, you will get an expression for a1 and a2. Once you know that a1 and a2, you substitute that one in the main equation. What is the main equation? V of t equal to a1 e power minus t plus a2 e power minus 6t. So a1, a2 you substitute here, you will get the expression.